I'm Brittany Duncan. I'm an assistant professor in the Computer Science and Engineering Department at University of Nebraska-Lincoln. I'm interested in how people will interact with drones as they become more prevalent in public spaces. So for instance, you're at your kid's soccer game and you see a drone buzzing around because somebody's taking video or film. And so you want to know how this drone is interacting, if something's wrong with it, how it would communicate that. And you can also think about if you were here on campus and we wanted to give you a tour of campus, we might have drones someday that could do that. If they were, how would they approach you and how would that make you feel? Two of the major things I'm going to look at, how people distance from robots. And so to do that, I'll actually have robots approach them. And as they're coming closer, then when people feel uncomfortable, they'll say stop. But we'll also look at their body language, their facial expressions. We'll ask them questions to see how they felt in the interaction, to really triangulate down on when they felt uncomfortable and what might make them feel more comfortable. On the other side, we're also looking at how things like this model could be used for random people to come in and say, well, how would this robot communicate to you if it needed to land? The impacts of this research hopefully are getting broader by the day. 10 years ago, the AR drone was introduced, and we didn't know that drones would be such a big part of our lives now. We didn't know that Amazon would think about delivering packages to our house. We didn't know that agricultural operations would use them to know if your apples are ripe. And so we're thinking 10 years in the future, these will hopefully be closer to our personal spaces. So they may be used in nursing homes. They may be used closer to our families to check out our house or do security. And as they do that, they'll need to become more communicative. You'll need to feel safer around them.